Have you ever looked at your keyboard and wondered if there's something better you can do with the caps lock key? If you're like me, you never use the caps lock key, at least not as caps lock. You can reassign it to be another modifier key or turn it off if you find yourself accidentally hitting it. And it's easy to do. It's right in System Preferences. So you want to go to System Preferences and then in there go to Keyboard and then select Keyboard at the upper left here. Then click on the Modifier Keys button. And now you get a list of the four modifier keys. Shift key isn't offered as one of the options, even though that's technically a modifier key. So you've got Control, Option, and Command here, and you can actually reassign these. So for instance, if you're a Windows user and you're used to Command and Control being reversed on your keyboard, you may want to reassign it so Control is Command and Command is Control. But I recommend you don't do that. Get used to the new Mac layout because if you reassign them and then you sit down at another Mac, you're going to find yourself having a hard time using it. So I recommend keeping these three keys the same. But caps lock key, certainly you could change. And you can see your options here to use one of the existing modifier keys, which could be useful, much more useful than caps lock is. So for instance, if you wanted to have an alternative to the option key to use caps lock instead, you could assign option to caps lock. You could also assign escape, the escape key, to caps lock. This is very useful, especially if you have a new MacBook Pro with the touch bar at the top and the escape key is now in software. And if you're a developer, you may want to have a hardware escape key, something you can physically hit if the touch bar isn't working while, say, you're developing your app. So it's very useful to assign escape to caps lock. And the other option, which you should probably choose if you decide you don't want any of this but you don't use caps lock at all, is no action, meaning that if you accidentally hit caps lock, it's not going to turn on. I mean, everybody's had that experience where they've tried to type a password and caps lock is accidentally on and the password's incorrect because everything's in uppercase and you can't see that. So for a lot of people, just simply switching to no action will actually improve your keyboard. And for others, you may want to choose a more useful function for caps lock.